90% of armed robbery attacks across Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. 98% of extrajudicial police killing in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo and Fulani. We have done the research. All the police who have ever been arrested in Yorubaland for killing people unjustly and non-Yoruba, 98% of them, the majority of whom are Igbo, we put guns in the hands of our enemy. Look at the way and manner the Igbo killed Demola. Look at the way and manner that man was manhandled and killed by the Igbo in Yorubaland. Look at the hatred they exhibited for us. They are coming from Kwara State to come and vote in Lagos. Igbo. And you put guns in the hands of these people as police officers, as military men, as custom officers, as immigration officers in Yorubaland. They will kill you. 85% of ritual and kidnapping cases in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. They kidnap our people. 90% of drug trafficking cases in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. 75% of organized crime, 419 in Yorubaland, are committed by the Igbo. 95% of pirated CD cases in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. Almost 100% of fake drug that have killed millions of people in Yorubaland are sold by the Igbo. 90% of vandalism cases in Yorubaland are Igbo people. 90% of cases of child and human trafficking in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. So they are flagging us seriously on YouTube. They will continue to flag us. Of street trading in Yorubaland are committed by the Igbo. They come into our space and constitute nuisance into our space. 100% of importation of substandard and prohibited goods are imported into Yorubaland by the Igbo. These are the crime of the Igbo in Yorubaland. 80% of cases of street begging in Yorubaland are committed by Igbo and Hausa Fulani. If Yorubaland is underdeveloped, Igbo will not be in our space. Why is it that the Yoruba are not going to Igbo land? It is not the federal government that developed Yoruba land. The only time that the Yoruba participating in being part of the federal government was in 2015 and the recent re-election of Buhari. It has been twice that we are now going to be in that federal government. Igbo have always been in that federal government since 1959. The first time the Yoruba nation was part of the federal government was 2015, and the second time is 2019 in an election that has just been won. Federal government did not develop Yoruba land. Are they bringing money from Sokoto, Kano, Kaduna, or from Kanuri land, or from Igbo land to build Lagos? No! Federal government is stealing our wealth in Yoruba land, and we will end this. We will end this. They will not be in our space. Igbo will not be in Yorubaland if Yorubaland is not developed. So you did not develop Lagos. What exactly you are doing in Lagos, we know it. Igbo. Your achievements and economic advancement contribution by the Igbo to Lagos are as follows. You sell Tokumbo and fix spare parts at large equal market. These are your achievements. You sell China electronics and pirated CD at Alaba market. We will use large equal market to build housing estate. Believe you me, I have secret information about that. Large equal market will be used to build housing estate. Alaba market will be used to build hospital. Big hospitals. You know that Ikeja Computer Village was designated for a residential building. These things will come down. It will come down massively on you. You cannot constitute nuisance into other people's space. You must think home. We never sent you a letter inviting you to come to Yorubaland. We never stop your grandfather from getting out of Nigeria. You first attacked the Yoruba in January 1966. You killed our mother Nare Onokakafo in 1966. We did not revenge. You kill Hausa Fulani leader in 1966 January. It was only Hausa Fulani people that revenged on you in July 1966. They killed all of you in the north. You ran back to the east. Then a year after that incident, you declared Biafra. Rather than for you to face the people that you are fighting with, the Hausa Fulani in the north, you were killing Urobo people, you were killing Ijaw people, you were killing Benin people, and you had the effrontery to go into war and massacre our people. It was because of that we would get involved in that war and kill you for the what you have done. We did not stop you. You stop yourself. You destroy regional government. Without Nigeria going back to regional government, believe you me, ile onigba ona onigba lo ma seyin Igbo. Until we massacre you in Yoruba land, you will never accept the fact that we have to go back to regional government. This is what you do. This is your business achievement. You sell bend down and select clothes, second-hand clothing at Idumota, Yaba, and Kotangora market. These are the shit businesses you do. You are selling Chinese and Tokumbo computer phones and accessory at Computer Village Ikeja. You do horrible shit. These are your economic achievement and contribution to Lagos State. You do not contribute anything to Lagos State. We don't want these shit things that you are doing. You are constituting nuisance. Who are the people that are contributing economically to Lagos State? Even not talking about the rest of the Yoruba. These are the companies that is the reason why people are coming to Lagos State. None is owned by you, Igbo. First, it is because of coming to Lagos because of PZ. It is not owned by Igbo. Coca-Cola is not owned by Igbo. 7-Up is not owned by Igbo. Cadbury is not owned by Igbo. MTN is not owned by Igbo. Zen is not owned by Igbo. Glow is not owned by Igbo. Etisalat is not owned by Igbo. Dangote is not owned by Igbo. ShopRite is not owned by Igbo. Golden Penny, Flour Mill, Indomie, Unilever, P&G. These are companies that have established businesses in Lagos and across Yoruba land. And these are the reason why people are moving to Lagos. These are businesses that are not owned by the Igbo. These are businesses that are contributing economically to the growth of Lagos State. We appreciate them. We recognize this fact. And that is why we are speaking out about them. You have contributed nothing, you Igbo. You don't have the human capital. You don't have the brain. You are crude. We talk about Chi Limited. We talk about Tower. We talk about J.W. Bush. We talk about Baco. We talk about Guinness, Nigerian Breweries, Ohando, Corn Oil, Total, Mogul, Chevron, Fort Oil, South Atlantic Oil, ENI Oil, Shell, KFC, Aquadana, Eco Hotel, Oriental Hotel, Intercontinental Hotel, Protea Hotel, Julius Berger, RCC, Construction, Nestu, KPMG, JSK, Finland Food, Wamco, British American Tobacco. These are businesses that are in Lagos and across Yoruba land. They are not owned by Igbo. These are why people are coming to our space to work, to live, and get education. None of these are owned by Igbo. These are owned by Yoruba and foreigners who are not even from Nigeria. Slum Burger, AIT, TVC, Silverball TV, Channel TV, Lafarge. There are several thousands of these businesses never owned by you, Igbo. You don't have the human capital. You come to Yoruba land as armed robbers. You come with your bedroom slippers, with your nylon bag, to constitute nuisance into our space. And you have no respect for us. A Yoruba man from Ilesha can never contest the stool of Lagos State, Oba. A Yoruba man from Akoko will never say to you that he wants to be Oba of Lagos. Stupid Igbo who are foreigners, not even Yoruba, telling you that Lagos is no man's land. Everybody has a pride of place, except the Igbo in Nigeria. Hausa Fulani pride of place is Kano. Yoruba pride of place is Lagos. The people of Edo pride of place is Benin City. The Ijaw people are proud of River States. Kanuri people talk about their whole. Sometime Maiduguri, sometime Bono. What is your pride of place, Igbo? You've got nothing. You use your passion to claim other people's space. When you're irresponsible parents, instead of them to give you qualitative education, they were wasting your life away. That's why you are being killed. You do drugs all across the world. You said you build Lagos. These are the businesses that are in Lagos that are contributing taxes. And we respect them. Who are you in Igbo? You are not even second-class citizen. Yoruba from Brazil, Cuba, Puerto Rico, they have better leverage than you in Yoruba and Igbo. We have no respect for you. And it is clear that you must obey us. Otherwise, we will waste you